Welcome back to our 9-month ultimate world cruise adventure, and today we've made it to the beautiful, beautiful islands in French Polynesia and the most idyllic sail-in we've ever had.
Welcome to Living Phase 2.
Hi, I'm Mike.
And I'm Nancy, and we're empty nesters striving to live life to the fullest.
And we're living that full life aboard Royal Caribbean's 9-month Ultimate World Cruise on Serenade of the Seas.
We sure are. Well, friends, today we are in Moorea. It's one of the islands of Tahiti.
In French Polynesia.
In French Polynesia. Yep. And It is beautiful. Oh, my goodness. Before we even got off the ship, I said, we're coming back. And I hadn't even stepped foot on the island of Moorea.
That's right.
We are coming back here.
Yeah, you actually stepped out a little before me to go up to get some breakfast. And I suddenly get this text that goes, get up on the helipad right now. You've got to go see it. And so we ran up to look at the helipad area that's the front of the ship. And it was stunning. I mean, it almost looked artificial. It was so beautiful.
It really did.
It looked like CGI or something. Your eyes almost couldn't take it all in. And so it really was. Moorea is one of the Society Islands. That includes like Bora Bora, Tahiti, Moorea, a bunch of other islands. And it is one of the least developed islands. So it's not like Tahiti. When you go over there, you're going to find that much more, almost like going to Oahu with Honolulu. I mean, not that big, but much bigger. But Moorea is very undeveloped, very beautiful, very nature.
18,000 people who live on Moorea.
Yeah, exactly. And so there is no dock. It's a tender port. So we took a tender over to get on shore. And we ended up getting in a bit early, so we took our tender over because our tour wasn't actually till 2 o'clock. We had a island safari tour scheduled, but we thought we'd go ahead and go ashore and just find out what there is to do.
Right, we got off the ship. There was a lovely greeting with the hula dancers the Tahitian dancers.
Yes.
And we got our picture taken with them. There was the straw market was there where they had black pearls are very famous in the islands. And so a lot of people were selling black pearl jewelry. I didn't get any. But
what we did is at that area, they had a tourist information person, and we just walked up and said, hey, you know, what's to go on?
We've got a few hours here.
Yeah, what can we do to explore your island in a few hours on foot? And unfortunately, we were there on a Sunday, so there wasn't a lot open. That's kind of a pro tip here. If you're at a place like this, especially these less developed islands, you know, there is nothing open on Sundays. So,
church services are very limited, and we were not able to make it to a church service.
Right. They all were about 10 o'clock in the morning. Well, the tourist information person was very friendly, and when asking her what there was to do, she said, well, if you go to the right out of the port, there's somebody selling like juices and fruits and things. If you go to the left, about a 20-minute walk, you can see Magic Mountain. And we thought, oh, that sounds nice. And, you know, a little 20-minute hike, and we get this beautiful view. And, well, it was 20 minutes to the base of the mountain, and there was another kind of fruit and juice stand there, and she asked for like $2 to get on the road to go up Magic Mountain. We thought, oh, well, we've got till 2 o'clock. It's only what it was about 9-10 o'clock. It was 10 o'clock in the morning.
She said it was about an hour and a half round trip hike around Magic Mountain.
Right. So we said, let's do it. Let's hike up the mountain, and we went.
It was strenuous.
It was about 85 degrees,
yes.
And we started walking. Magic Mountain is about 1,000-foot elevation from sea level
and
up
steep.
To Magic Mountain.
Oh, yeah.
Very steep.
Yeah, so we had to stop often because it was just, it was exhausting, really. You have to be in you know, relatively well prepared and in somewhat good shape to take this hike because it was strenuous.
Bring plenty of water.
Yes.
But just take your time because there is no reason to hurry because the views are spectacular all the way up. There's many places where you can view the bay, view the island, view the valleys, the mountains.
It was gorgeous. Cruise ship. It was stunning. It truly was.
And we did get to the very top. The view was really worth it. It was worth the hike. It really was. And so you can see some of those views.
Yes, and on our way up, we had a safari tour planned for later in the day, and some of our shipmates went mm-hmm. on a safari tour in the morning. Mm-hmm.
The same tour.
On the same tour. And we passed them. They were coming down as we were going up.
Right. They're like, what are you doing walking up? You're going to be on this tour. And so we said, you know what? But you're cheating. We're walking up. You took a 4x4 up to the top. So, but yeah, we had a good laugh about that. And we made our way back down the mountain. And we actually did stop at the little... stand at the bottom. We had a fruit smoothie. Mm-hmm. That was very good. Drank about 2 liters of water to replenish ourselves. Yeah. And we walked back to the port to get ready for our 4x4 safari, which right when we got back, we had just a few minutes and we got on the safari wagons, right? Yeah.
So the safari is basically, it's a pickup truck with some cushioned seats in the bed of the truck. Mm-hmm. Not very cushioned because it was really rough, friends. Oh, mm-hmm. my goodness. It was so rough. And the first place they took us was back to Magic Mountain.
And they climbed it. And I didn't think that truck was going to make it. The clutch was smoking, because it's so steep going up there. But the little truck that could did make us up there. And, obviously we had just been there about 2 hours before that. So we let everyone get their views, got back in the truck, took us back down to the bottom, and then we went on effectively just kind of a loop around the island. Yeah. The first place we went was Pineapple Fields. And of course, like most of the Polynesian islands, Moorea is an old volcano. And so the soil is incredibly fertile. And where the pineapples grow best is in the old caldera of the volcano. So they took us in there. We saw some of the pineapples, how they grow, got some beautiful, beautiful views, and, drove through some a stream, saw some eels.
Yeah, it really was a pretty drive. Mm-hmm. But yeah. all things said and done, at least for Magic Mountain, I enjoyed the walk, the hike. More than I enjoyed.
You say that now. I don't think you were saying that.
Maybe I wasn't saying that when we were climbing it, but really the views were much mm-hmm. more beautiful. We were able
to... You could take your time.
We could stop, mm-hmm. exactly, take some beautiful pictures. And mm-hmm. actually, I do want to throw in, too, for those of you that have been following along for a while, about a year ago, I was letting you know that I've got degenerative disc disease mm-hmm. in my back, and I was kind of on a quest to do a lot of walking before. I said mm-hmm. I'd do 590 miles before my 59th birthday, which was an average of 4 miles mm-hmm. a day at the time. And that really has helped my back. Mm-hmm. I think it's helped a lot on this trip. We're active. We keep moving. And really mm-hmm. my back, we're about a year in now from when I was diagnosed. My back is so much better mm-hmm. than it was, because there were a couple of times mm-hmm. it was like, oh my goodness, Mike, I can't even get up. Mm-hmm. I can't even stand up. I don't mm-hmm. have the strength or the, mm-hmm. and things are better.
Yeah, so, you've done fantastic. You yeah, really have
so just,
working
just
out
a and, tip. Yeah, and keep walking. Moving, and, people. Mm-hmm. Keep moving, friends. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yep. So after the Pineapple Fields, we went to what's called Belvedere Point, mm-hmm. which is kind of up on the edge of the caldera. And again, very, very beautiful views. It was worth a stop. It's one of the stops most... tours are going to take you out here in Moorea if you're on an inland tour. After that, the safari took us around through Cook's Bay and then around to the bay where our ship was anchored to a... we made a quick stop at a black sand beach, and then the safari took us back to the ship. This is where we want to say... I mean, we always try to be honest with everyone, not big drama. We always try to be positive. But in this case, I would say for me, this safari was a little disappointing. It was supposed to be about 4 hours. Part of it is because we were there on a Sunday. Mm-hmm. They didn't tell us that we weren't going to make some of the stops. We were supposed to go to a vanilla plantation, to a rum distillery. All those were closed on Sundays, which we did not know. And so we ended up getting only a little more than half the time of the safari that we were... had paid for and scheduled. Not a lot of narration as we went. In this one, I would say if you're coming to Moorea, walk up Magic Mountain if you have the physical capability to do it. Or just if you're just here for a little bit, go snorkeling. This is a snorkel spot. We had several friends that went snorkeling. They saw rays, they saw sharks, they saw fish. The water is crystal clear and blue. Beautiful. It's protected by a reef. They loved it. And I think this is a stop where I kind of wish we'd went snorkeling.
We had other friends that took a a clear kayak boat, mm-hmm. so they were kayaking mm-hmm. and could see through the boat all the fish, and that uh-huh. would be a fun thing to do as well.
Right, and I'm going to guess, this is Leslie on Point My Soul North, I'm going to guess she's going to post on that adventure, so mm-hmm. take a look at her channel and you'll get to see some of her things for Moorea as mm-hmm. well. And they actually rented e-bikes and just kind of went for an e-bike around, and they really enjoyed that.
Again,
so
there's not much traffic on the island, really.
No, especially on a Sunday. Mm-hmm. So again, Moorea is very natural. It's just full mm-hmm. of beauty. I would highly recommend a snorkeling trip here. If mm-hmm. And so I guess that's the question. We answer that a lot. Would we, as what we've seen so far, we haven't been over to the island of Tahiti, which you can see from Moorea. it's only a 20-minute ferry ride over there. Would you come back knowing what we know now?
I think this would be a beautiful island to come to for a week of just pure relaxation. Just mm-hmm. bring several books along mm-hmm. and just complete relaxation. Mm-hmm. And you could take a ferry mm-hmm. to Tahiti.
Yes.
Or to some of
it's
the
only
other 20
minutes
islands.
Over there, 25
yeah.
minutes. Yeah.
And it's not very expensive mm-hmm. to take a ferry. So mm-hmm. I would absolutely come back just for the beauty.
Yeah, it is gorgeous. The water is just this beautiful blue, almost like we saw in Curacao. They have the overwater bungalows. They have, yeah, I think it would be a great island, as you said, just to come for a pure vacation.
Yes.
Relax, just enjoy the scenery, and the local people are so friendly, and just snorkel and enjoy it. I would agree right. with you.
Well, after we were done with our safari, friends, we headed back to the ship. We went on our tender boat to the ship mm-hmm. and we ate in the main dining room. They're having specialty meals that reflect each of the places that we're going to mm-hmm. and tonight they were having hula chicken.
There's
that sounded
hula chicken
hula
yeah
hula, sounded yeah. quite good
uh-huh. and it was good
it mm-hmm. was very good.
It's kind of a pineapple chicken dish. It was really good.
Teriyaki,
yeah.
mm-hmm. maybe.
With coconut rice. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. It was really good.
And we skipped the show because we were exhausted.
It was a busy day. Yeah. Climbing up the mountain.
I had 18,000 steps that yeah. I took. So it was a lot.
Yeah. Yep. It was a good day. Well, the next day we're heading to the sister island over here, which is only a 25-minute ferry ride, but we're going to take all night to get over there to Tahiti. And there we're going to actually have a private guide. We are going to do some snorkeling, and little heads up, this was an excellent, excellent day. We enjoyed it a lot. So be sure to tune into the next video on Tahiti.
Yeah, so like, subscribe, turn on those notifications. I'm going to answer real quick a viewer question. We get asked a lot about how are we handling our money as far as exchanges, because it's different currencies in all of these different countries. Mm-hmm. And really, friends, it's been pretty easy because most places will take credit cards. So we have that. Mm-hmm. The little straw markets that are at the ports, so far, they've all taken U.S. dollars mm-hmm. and it hasn't been any issue. We could potentially go to an ATM and take some money mm-hmm. out in a local currency
right.
if needed. And then the ship will exchange back many of those currencies back. We're going to lose a little bit of money on the exchange, mm-hmm. but that's always an option mm-hmm. as well. So there's just ways, yeah, to handle it. We did bring along mm-hmm. some euros ahead of time.
And a few other currencies mm-hmm. that we had, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So we did prepare and stop at the bank ahead of time for that. And mm-hmm. that is how we handle all right. these different exchanges.
Right, and one thing just to add to that is, as Nancy mentioned, you're going to get your best exchange rate from a bank ATM. So be very careful which ATMs you pick. Some mm-hmm. are going to have very high fees, but if you can go to an actual bank, to the ATM that's attached to that bank, that is going to give you the best exchange rate to draw out local currency, and that's how right. we normally do it if we do need local currency. Other than that, you're also going to get your best exchange rate with through a credit card. So
right, yep. And we did bring along, as a side note, we did bring along multiple credit cards just because we figured at some point in time mm-hmm. our credit card could get compromised, and so we've kind of got them organized. This is the first card mm-hmm. credit card we'll use, and if it gets compromised, mm-hmm. this is the second and the third.
Right.
So mm-hmm.
that's how we're handling money.
It is. Mm-hmm. All right. Have a beautiful day, friends. We will see you soon. Take care.
Bye-bye.